is going on, guys? We're back here again today. Hope everyone's doing well. So I thought I would take a minute to test out this new Sigma 16mm f1.4 lens. So far, I gotta say, man, this thing is awesome. It is really sharp. So anybody with an a6400, 6600 mirrorless camera, if you run a few YouTube searches as far as popular lenses, there's a good chance you're gonna stumble upon the Sigma 16mm f1.4. And I gotta say, this lens is absolutely razor sharp. With 1.4 aperture, I'm just absolutely loving this awesome blurry background, really nice shallow depth of field. I've got nothing but great things to say so far. Now, coming from the 16-50mm kit lens, I gotta say, the Sigma 16mm f1.4 really knocks out of the park. I mean, just the intensity of the color, everything feels so much more refined. The image quality is just so razor sharp. I really think it's a big step up from the 16-50mm kit lens. Another thing I find really impressive is how responsive the autofocus is. I don't feel like the autofocus is constantly hunting. I feel like it does a good job of staying focused. Yeah, it's just amazing how the autofocus is so responsive for not being a native Sony lens. So as you guys know, I'm using the Sony a6600 mirrorless camera. I've been really happy with it so far. I'm a huge fan of this camera specifically because, unlike a lot of the other Sony APS-C cameras, this one does have in-body image stabilization. In-body image stabilization is such a great feature. I really feel like, especially in a case like this where I'm using the Sigma 16mm lens, it is not optically stabilized. So it really is nice to have the in-body image stabilization to fall back on. Now, one thing I will say about having this wide 1.4 aperture, right now we're a late afternoon, so as you can see, it's not super, super crazy bright outside. I don't feel like I'm running into any issues as far as overexposure. Now, on a super bright sunny day, there's a good chance, with the 1.4 aperture being as wide as it is, you probably would benefit from using like an ND filter just to make sure that you're not getting too much exposure. Probably something I'll be picking up here in the near future. But I gotta say, I'm just really impressed at how smooth everything is. I really thought it was gonna be a lot more of an issue just not being optically stabilized. Once again, huge benefit of running the a6600 with in-body image stabilization. Something else important I should mention, I would say it goes without saying, I'm a pretty average everyday guy with a camera. I'm just a person making casual YouTube videos. I'm not a photographer, I'm not a professional videographer, I'm not a filmmaker. I strictly speak from personal experience, just in the short time that I've had this camera, testing out different lenses. If you want more professional opinions, if you want people that are doing a little bit more in-depth technical breakdowns, there's a fine assortment of much more in-depth videos on YouTube that you can definitely check out. Man, I gotta say, this 16mm is pretty hefty. Definitely starting to feel it on the arm as I'm holding it on my GorillaPod here. All right, so one other test for you guys on the 16mm f1.4. Just thought it'd be a good idea to go ahead and test out in the garage, see how it does. You guys had seen a couple weeks ago, I had posted several videos in this same garage setting with my kit lens, the 16-50, and I'd say it was overall, acceptable, nothing spectacular by any means. Really, the biggest limitation with the kit lens, you can only get your aperture down to 3.5, so you are kind of limited, once again, in that low light setting. So I can say with confidence, it seems like at 1.4, we're doing a lot better low light in the garage with the Lamborghini. Now, something else worth mentioning when using the 16mm lens is it's a pretty heavy lens. It's got some decent heft to it. You could obviously use your GorillaPod. That's totally fine. It is a bit front heavy. So what you can actually do, instead of using the GorillaPod, you can actually just hold the camera right in front of you by the lens, which I'm doing right now. So for me, I could actually use this in a vlog setting at a comfortable reach, just holding it by the lens itself. I don't even feel like I actually need a GorillaPod. As you can see, I'm just kind of holding this out at arm's length, and I feel like I've still got a pretty decent amount of space at 16mm. So overall thoughts, guys, on the 16mm lens. I've got nothing but great things to say. This lens is fantastic. I think this is a great choice for any owner of any Sony A6000 series camera. Definitely pick one up. I don't think you'll be disappointed. Well, let me know what you guys think. Leave a comment down below. Let me know your favorite camera and lens combination. I'm interested to hear your thoughts. So that's gonna go ahead and wrap it up for today's video, guys. Thank you so much for checking it out. I'm gonna leave a link in the description box below just in case you wanna pick up one of these Sigma 16mm lenses. Make sure to give the video a thumbs up, subscribe for more. I will see you guys in the next one. Have a great day.